¿Cuál fue el mejor gol de tu carrera?
Contra el Madrid en Bernabéu.
Ronaldinho is a Brazilian soccer player whose talent borders on magic. In the mid-2000s, he made Barcelona great again, performing fantastic dummies and scoring crazy goals. But over time, he began to smile less and less on the field, and his career came to naught. We will tell you the story of how it happened in this video. Where is Ronaldinho now? The death of a soccer wizard's career. Ronaldo de Assis Moreira, better known as Ronaldinho, was born on March 21, 1980, in the Brazilian city of Porto Alegre. His mother, Dona Miguelina, worked as a saleswoman who studied to become a nurse, and his father, João, worked two jobs to support the family. During the day, the man repaired ships at the shipyard, and at night, he guarded the parking lot of the local soccer club, Grêmio. The boy was the youngest of three children in the family. He has a brother, Roberto, and a sister, Daisy. Both boys played soccer. Ronaldo attended the Grêmio Children's Soccer School from the age of seven. And even then, great hopes were pinned on Roberto, who was often compared to Diego Maradona. Two professional clubs fought for him and even provided his family with a house with a swimming pool in the prestigious area of Porto Alegre. But his father was assuring everyone that Ronaldo was the best soccer player in the family. He also often said that the youngest son would one day become the world champion. João didn't have a chance to see the realization of his prophecy. He died of a heart attack while swimming in that very new pool in 1989, when Ronaldo was 8 years old. The boy received the nickname Ronaldinho, which means Little Ronaldo, in soccer school, as he was the youngest player on the team. Later, in order to distinguish himself from fellow Brazilian soccer player Ronaldo, he added the prefix Gaucho to his nickname, which refers to his origin. The boy couldn't live a day without soccer. The ball was always at his feet, and his beloved dog Bon Bon was his sparring partner. She wasn't very technical, but she never got tired. Ronaldinho mastered her skills right in his home living room, juggling a tennis ball and coming up with various tricks. As well as soccer, Ronaldinho played beach soccer and futsal. The Brazilian was 13 years old when his name first appeared in the Brazilian media. This happened after the futsal team, Belo Horizonte, won a match with a score of 23-0, all goals scored by one player, Ronaldinho. From the age of 15, the young soccer player played for the youth team Grêmio. In 1997, he won the World Youth Championship with the Brazilian national team, in which he scored 2 points from the penalty spot. In 1998, Ronaldinho made his debut in the first team squad of Grêmio in a Copa Libertadores match. A year later, the soccer player won his first serious tournament, the Rio Grande do Sul State Championship, in which he scored 15 goals in 14 games. Even though he was the most prominent figure at the club, he received almost the least money among his teammates and could spend almost all of his savings on paying off his friends' debts. In June 1999, the player made his debut in the Brazilian national team in an exhibition match with Latvia. In the same year at the America Cup, he shined for the country's main team for the first time, scoring a goal against Venezuela. He was soon called up to the 1999 FIFA Confederations Cup and scored in every match except the final. He also scored a hat-trick in the semifinals. Then Ronaldinho received the Golden Ball Award for the best player in the tournament, as well as the Golden Boot for the tournament's top scorer. After that, European clubs became interested in the young talent, but Grêmio rejected all offers and demanded compensation according to Pelé's law, which was 200 times higher than the player's salary. London Arsenal almost completed the contract, but the young man couldn't get permission to work in England. In September of 2000, Ronaldinho played for the youth team at the Sydney Summer Olympics, scoring one goal in a losing quarterfinal match. In December, the player signed a preliminary contract with Paris Saint-Germain, keeping it a secret from the management of Grêmio. On January 17, 2001, the French club announced the transfer for 5.1 million euros. This started legal proceedings with Grêmio. The player was declared a traitor, and any of his actions on the field in the last months before the end of the contract were accompanied by boos and whistles. In just 4 years at his home club, Ronaldinho played in 141 matches and scored 68 goals, including official and exhibition games. Ronaldinho's brother, Roberto, played a big role in the transfer of the Brazilian to PSG. Roberto's own career went downhill after an injury. Since then, Roberto has become Ronaldinho's agent agent and mentor, and his sister works as a media relations coordinator. The upcoming transfer to Paris Saint-Germain was also mentioned in an episode of the famous Brazilian TV series Clone, in which Ronaldinho appeared. After a while, he appeared in another movie, playing himself again in Shooting Stars. For the new club, the soccer player made his debut in a French league match on August 4th, 2001, as number 21. But he didn't get in the first team squad right away and often started matches on the bench. In the second half of the season, Ronaldinho performed an amazing streak of goals, scoring in four straight games, and helped the team advance to the 2001-2002 League Cup semifinals. However, the season was marred by controversy with the club's manager, who argued that the Brazilian was more focused on the nightlife of Paris than soccer. Ronaldinho came to the 2002 World Cup as a talented young player, but left it as one of the main soccer stars on the planet. First, he shined in the group stage match against the Chinese national team, and then, in a game with England in the quarterfinals, he crafted one of his main goals in his career. He hit the opponent's goal with a free kick from a distance of 115 feet, kicking the ball over the goalkeeper's collar. Although the Brazilian was sent off in the same match, he forever remained the main hero of the match. Many years later, in a charity game between the stars of England and the world team, Ronaldinho tried to repeat the same trick but shot well above the goal. In the final game, the wizard helped his compatriots win the main soccer trophy and become the world champion at the age of 22. Returning to the club, the player changed his number to 10 and began to get into the starting 11 more often. However, at the end of the season, PSG did not qualify for the European competition and Ronaldinho announced that he wanted to leave the team. He almost got a deal with Manchester United, but Barcelona intercepted the talented Brazilian. On July 19, 2003, after very difficult negotiations, Ronaldinho became a Barcelona player who was paid over 32 million euros for the transfer. There is no exact data on the salary of the soccer player in the new club, but the media mentioned the amount of $10 million per season. In his first season, he scored 22 goals and helped Barcelona take second place in the Spanish championship. On December 20, 2004, FIFA awarded him the title of the best soccer player in the world. In February 2005, the athlete had a son who was named João after Ronaldinho's father. Ronaldinho had met the mother of his son, Brazilian Janaina Mendes, who was a nightclub dancer, 3 years earlier, but soon the young parents separated. The athlete provided the child with everything he needed and rented a mansion for his former love in the elite district of Rio, but communicated with João more often online. The wizard's son followed in his father's footsteps and is now one of the most promising soccer players of the Cruzeiro Academy. At the end of the 2004-2005 season, Ronaldinho, together with Barcelona, won the title championship of Spain. He was recognized as the best soccer player in the world for the second time in a row and also received the Golden Ball Award. The following season, the Brazilian set a personal record for the most number of goals, scoring 26 goals, and he received an offer to transfer to Chelsea for 70 million euros, but Barca refused. In June 2006, the Brazilian national team failed to beat France in the quarterfinals. The fans pounced on the players with criticism. When Ronaldinho threw a party after the loss, it only complicated the situation. The new girlfriend of the star of the Brazilian national team, French model Alexandra Parisant, was considered one of the culprits of his unsuccessful performance. According to rumors, he violated the regime before the matches because of her. However, the passion quickly subsided, and the athlete soon parted ways with the model. In 2006, the soccer player's total earnings were $26 million, thanks to advertising contracts. And also, since that year, Ronaldinho has been playing an official role in UNICEF, the United Nations Children's Fund, and regularly participates in the Soccer Aid program, which raises money for charity. On May 24, 2007, Ronaldinho scored twice against Chile, thus ending his two-year goalless streak with the national team. In the same year, he refused to go to the American Cup because of fatigue. In October, he became involved in another scandal. After defeating the Ecuadorian national team, he and his teammates had fun all night in a nightclub in Rio de Janeiro, so they were late for Barcelona's training camp because of this. In 2007, the soccer player received Spanish citizenship, although things at the club were not going well. The 2007-2008 season was accompanied by injuries, and the coach was unhappy with the Brazilian's attitude to training. On May 19, 2008, the Barcelona president said that Ronaldinho needed a new challenge and a new club if he wanted to revive his career. Ronaldinho later admitted that 5 years with the Catalan team were the best in his career. He also regretted that he didn't play long enough with Messi, to whom he handed over his number 10. In July 2008, Ronaldinho turned down an offer from Manchester City and joined Milan in the Italian Serie A. There, the player's annual salary reached 6.5 million euros. Since his favorite number 10 was already taken, he chose number 80, the year of his birth. Also, the owner of the Golden Ball managed to play for the Brazilian Olympic team, which won the bronze medal in Beijing in 2008. This was the last major international tournament for Ronaldinho. In August 2008, Ronaldinho made his debut with Milan. He scored his first goal for the club in September. Despite a fairly good start, Ronaldinho stopped appearing in the starting 11 in the middle of the season. The reason for this was that the athlete preferred to spend time in Italian nightclubs again. In total, Ronaldinho played 36 matches and scored 10 goals in his first season with Milan. Around that time, the soccer player started an affair with actress and TV presenter Sara Tomasi, and their relationship lasted about 3 years. Ronaldinho didn't start his second season at Milan on a high note, but soon he got back into shape and eventually became the best assistant in Serie A with 15 assists. In the next 2010-2011 season, the Brazilian stopped showing a high performance level again. He clashed with the head coach and increasingly violated the regime. Meanwhile, he began dating a young Romanian model and art student, Lilana Severasan, whom he met at a fashion show. Like all the previous ones, this romance ended quickly. On January 10, 2011, Ronaldinho moved to the Brazilian club Flamengo. He helped them win several titles, but about a year after signing the contract, he sued the club for non-payment of salaries for 4 months and canceled his contract. His annual salary was $22 million at the time. Also in 2011, the soccer player joined the information campaign of the Joint United Nations Program on HIV/AIDS and the Brazilian Ministry of Health to raise awareness among young people about how to protect themselves from AIDS. Just 4 days after leaving Flamengo, on June 4, 2012, the Brazilian signed a contract with Atlético Mineiro, where he took number 49 as a tribute to his mother, who was born in 1949. With his team, Ronaldinho won the 2013 Copa Libertadores and the 2014 South American Cup. In 2014, according to local media, the soccer player had a hard relationship with the new head coach, so he terminated his contract with Atlético Mineiro in July and transferred to the Mexican club Querétaro as a free agent. Ronaldinho said in an interview that he would continue to win titles and girls in Mexico. It didn't work out with titles, but that can't be said about girls. The athlete began dating a model and beauty queen, 20-year-old Jacqueline Oliverio. Also, Ronaldinho was in a relationship with the model and winner of the 2011 Miss Universe crown, Leila Lopez, for some time. In July 2015, Ronaldinho announced his return to Brazil and signed an 18-month deal with Fluminense to receive $2.5 million and a percentage of the sales of t-shirts with his name over the season. During his 2 months at the club, he played 9 matches but did not make a good impression and was severely criticized by fans, so he decided to terminate the contract. After that, the famous Brazilian played in several charity matches, took part in a futsal tournament in Goa for a fee of $500,000, starred in the film Kickboxer Returns, and released his own mobile application, Emojinho. In September 2016, Ronaldinho became the official ambassador of FC Barcelona and attended the opening ceremony of their new office in New York and their school in the Bronx. In 2017, Ronaldinho released the musical single Sozinho. Eu agora sozinho. He had previously recorded songs, one of which was dedicated to the Summer Paralympic Games in Rio. In addition, he has constantly appeared in music videos of many Brazilian performers. He also took part in the match between veterans of Barcelona and Real, in which he made 3 assists. And attended several events in Russia. In January 2018, Ronaldinho announced the end of his soccer career. In the same year, the media reported that the man was planning to marry 2 girlfriends at once, contrary to the laws of Brazil. Priscila Coelho and Beatriz Salsa were called his chosen ones, But Ronaldinho called the story a huge lie. One way or another, in 2019, one of the girls, Priscilla, accused the athlete of domestic violence and demanded that he pay alimony, as well as a share of joint property. And Priscilla's mother said that Ronaldinho took turns spending nights with the girls, taking them on trips and giving the same gifts until her daughter discovered his correspondence with another woman. In addition to the proceedings with the ex-girlfriend, the athlete also received a ban on leaving the country in the case of causing environmental damage. Back in 2015, the celebrity was charged with construction in a conservation area. Ronaldinho and his brother had to pay a 2.3 million euro fine. But the prosecutor's office found only 6 euros in his account. Then the court decided to block 57 real estate objects and confiscate the passports of the two Brazilians for non-payment at the end of 2018. But the brothers complied with the order only at the beginning of the next year. Only after that did Ronaldinho make a deal with the prosecutor's office and agreed to pay a reduced fine of just over 1 million euros. In March 2020, the soccer player and his brother were caught trying to enter Paraguay with fake passports. According to the brothers, they just went through border control with the documents that they received from the organizer of the trip. Ronaldinho planned to take part in a charity event in Paraguay, but he had to spend a month in prison and then almost 5 more months under house arrest in a fashionable hotel. In prison, the owner of the Golden Ball managed to take part in a soccer tournament. In the decisive match, his team outplayed their rivals with a score of 11-2. He scored 5 of them himself and assisted his partners in the rest. As a prize for the winners, there were 35 pounds of smoked pork. After his release, Ronaldinho paid a fine and had to check in with the Brazilian court within a year. In January 2021, the former soccer player tried his hand at music again, becoming the producer of the hip-hop band Tropa de Bruxo, which translates as the Sorcerer's Squad. In February, Ronaldinho's mother died from improper COVID-19 treatment, which caused the soccer star to have problems with alcohol. According to his friends, he throws parties every day and drinks from morning to night. In May, Ronaldinho received a golden visa from the United Arab Emirates, which gives him the right to permanent residence in the country. The Brazilian's fortune is estimated from $90 to $100 million, although the direct funds are much less. Ronaldinho still earns from sponsorship contracts and advertising. For example, it is reported that a single celebrity's post on Instagram costs about $250,000. His music studio in Belo Horizonte also brings an additional income. During his career, the soccer player has partnered with EA Sports, appearing on the covers of FIFA video games, and has been active in commercials for a variety of brands. For example, he appeared in a Pepsi video alongside other soccer superstars in the guise of Roman gladiators and spoke Russian while promoting Lay's chips. His commercial for Nike was the most famous, in which the Brazilian juggled the ball and hit the crossbar 3 times, while the ball bounced back to the player and never landed on the ground. Even though many believe that the video was real, it still involved CGI. A huge green background was used to create the ad, and there was a special person behind the goal who was giving balls to the soccer player. The Brazilian also had a $750,000 contract with Coca-Cola, but he lost it after drinking a can of Pepsi at a press conference. Ronaldinho became the face of energy drinks, mobile phone brands, condoms, and bookmakers. In 2017, together with an Italian businessman, he launched a liquor line called Champion Wines. Ronaldinho owns a half a dozen houses around the world, in Brazil, Greece, Spain, France, Florida, and on Lake Como in Italy. The soccer player rented his house in Rio de Janeiro during the 2014 World Cup for $15,400 per day. The modern mansion has 5 bedrooms, 6 bathrooms, a kitchen, dining room, living room, bar, massage, and yoga room. And the adjacent area includes a swimming pool with a hot tub, another living room, and a garden. In Spain, Ronaldinho has a $16.5 million house 20 minutes from Barcelona. The highlight of this luxurious mansion is the infinity pool overlooking the Mediterranean Sea. It is also known that the house in which the soccer player lived in Milan was robbed while the owner was in Brazil. The criminals stole jewelry and valuables worth tens of thousands of euros. However, all of Ronaldinho's sports medals and trophies, including a copy of the Golden Ball, displayed in a separate room, were not touched by the burglars. Ronaldinho owns an impressive collection of cars that includes a Lamborghini Aventador, Porsche Carrera S, a yellow and black Ferrari 458, Rolls-Royce, a Bugatti Veyron, Audi R8, Audi Q7, Hummer H2, BMW X5, and an Aston Martin he bought for $1 million at the Saudi Arabian Auto Show. Once the Brazilian had a minor accident in Porto Alegre in his Dodge Durango. Perhaps Ronaldinho could have done much more in soccer. And still, his incredible soccer masterpieces have inspired the current generation of soccer players and gave fans an unforgettable experience. Why did the career of one of the most talented players in history end so quickly? What do you think? If you like the video, leave a like and also subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss anything interesting.